The monster holds onto a blade of grass, reaching its front legs out, ready to grab the next innocent bystander. If you saw it, you'd think it's a referee doing the touchdown signal. But no, this tick is questing. Not on a quest. I mean, it's sitting there, waiting for lunch in victory pose. It's really called questing in the tick world. But back to the eerie, hair-raising stuff. Cue the music! Right now, it's smelling and scanning the space around it. This beast is hungry, and it's waiting for you to get closer. Just a little more, almost there, and gotcha! You fell right into this parasite's ambush, and it's already crawling up your pants leg. Ticks aren't just forest dwellers, they're everywhere. In the city park or your beautiful suburban yard. Where you're not as likely to see one is crawling around on your walls. I mean, habitually. Like that guy right there. Yeah, him. Zoom in. Looks like a tick to me. No, zoom in closer. There, that's better. See, this is no tick. It's a crab spider. The Zysticus kind, to be exact. Since crab spiders come in all colors and sizes, oh, just you wait. For now, this little guy is brown. Easily recognizable from his longer forearms, make that longer forearms in the front, and shorter four back legs. Like a crab, yeah. Must have been what the scientist who named it thought, too. But it's mostly the way they move that won them the nickname. They walk sideways like a crab on the beach. From a distance, it looks like a tick. Up close, not really at all. The crab spider's body is broken up into two sections like any old regular spidey. Or, as they're called in the scientific community, arachnida hurry grab my slipperus. Okay, I made that second part up. Looking closely at a tick, you'll notice its body is just one solid flat piece. Well, flat before lunch. It's also slightly triangular. Now, grab a magnifying glass and look really close. I dare ya. You'll see crab spiders have 8 eyes. Ticks have none. Remember, they see the world by smelling with their feet. Weird, I know. Ticks are parasites. Duh. They feed on us and other animals like walking juice boxes. A crab spider has no interest in your blood. It's hunting for insects in your house. So, if you suddenly see more of these guys crawling around, it means their lunch has entered your home. So, don't be offended by them showing up uninvited. They're just going where the food is. And definitely, don't be so rude as to squish them. They're just trying to keep your house clean. They're hunting spiders, so they eat by going out and catching their grub. Not waiting around passively for a silk net to do all the work. Yeah, I'm looking at you, Black Widow. Okay, that's not entirely true. Crab spiders, like ticks, wait for lunch to come close enough. Then they use those long front legs to snatch it up and nom nom nom. And that's why they come in so many colors. The bright ones wait in ambush on vibrant flowers and fruits. The brown ones blend in better with tree branches and leaves. And crab spiders can produce silk. They just don't make webs. They use their built-in grappling hook to get around. And now, the million-dollar question. Do they wear fancy hats? No, I mean, are crab spiders venomous? Yep, sure are. But their tiny little mouth parts could never get through your skin or your pet's. So, rest easy. Now, the same can't be said about their cousin, the giant crab spider. It goes by another, more famous name, the huntsman spider. And this thing is big, ew, and fast. Its mouth parts can get through your skin, so don't touch them, just run. There you go. Now, when nature created this insect, it thought, let's do a butterfly with an alligator's head attached to it. Oh, and make it look like a peanut. There, ready. Scientists so graciously called this thing Fulgora latinaria, but peanut head sounds better. This peanut-headed lanternfly is large and, like a skunk, it knows how to let out an odorous spray to scare enemies away. Those menacing fake eyes on the wings help too. The strongest survives in the jungle. But what if you're small and defenseless? Option 1, hide your whole life. Option 2, pretend to be the baddest guy in the forest and everyone will be afraid of you. The caterpillar of the elephant hawk moth chose the second route. Ironically, it resembles neither an elephant nor a hawk. If an enemy shows up, this thing goes into snake mode. The caterpillar pulls its head into its body like a turtle. This puffs its body up, and it looks like a snake head. It's got fake eyes and everything. Oh, it puts on a whole show. It sways to the sides all serpent-like. Whatever was about to gobble it up decides, uh-oh, I'll just be on my way. Now, back to spiders. But wait, not all of them look like walking nightmares. Head to Hawaii to find the happy face spider. Its real face might not be especially joyous-looking for an arachnid, but the pattern on its back sure looks happy to see you. Fun fact, and that's what I do here, the pattern can change from the spider's food. I'd pay to see what it looks like when it eats something spicy. Whoa, watch out! A giant hornet coming right at you! Nah, just kidding. It's only another master of disguise. This is a hornet moth. No stingers, no worries. And this bug also has learned to mimic the movements of its fashion icon, the hornet. It flies with quick jerking motions. With the leaf bug, everything's clear. It walks and looks like a tree leaf, down to the finest detail. It even has brown spots around the edges to look like a leaf drying out. And their eggs look like seeds. The disguise is great, but Houston, we have a problem. The beetle has to remain motionless for most of its life. Hanging there, waiting for lunch to come by, and hoping their enemies don't catch on to the act. And here's the coolest part. If the insect needs to move, it starts dancing like a leaf blowing in the wind. The ghost mantis has also perfected the art of leaf mimicking. Only this guy's more into the autumn look. It's like a brown, crumpled leaf that's fallen from a tree. The mantis has a thin body, and the color depends on how much water is next to its tree and how much shadow is underneath it. When this insect hides, finding it is next to impossible. Perhaps you're more into the branchy look? Then I present to you the walking stick. This bug lives in trees and practically doesn't move. You're thinking, yeah, okay, I've seen those in my backyard, big whoop. But have you seen a gargantuan stick insect? The biggest one found is as long as your back. Bugs have even started copying simple thorns, though probably more effective than just a harmless leaf. The thorn bug's name says it all. Touch me and you'll get pricked. Come on, you wimp. But it's recruited its friends to help keep enemies away. They huddle together and turn an otherwise smooth, thornless branch into a spiny ouch place. Ow. Hungry birds see this, they're smart, and decide not to land there. Hey, who forgot to close the portal to the parallel universe full of unearthly monsters? Actually, you're still on Earth, and you share the planet with this thing. If you're in Southeast Asia or Australia anyways. Here's what the scientists call it, Creatinus gangus, but I'll name him Tentacle Bug. Yeah, Tentacle Bug doesn't usually look like this. He usually looks like your average moth, because that's what he is. But when he's trying to attract a partner, he shoots two pairs of massive tentacles from his bottom part. With them, the moth sprays not poison, but pheromones. Those are like smelly good chemicals that attract females. And it works, eh? To each his own. 12. Harvard scientists discovered 60 species of new insects in the jungles of Suriname. The main find was an unusual bug with grasshopper eyes and bizarre silvery hair. They dubbed it the troll-haired insect, because sometimes you just call it as you see it. That silver tail is a wax the insect puts out to keep enemies away. It also cushions the bug's landing when it falls. Imagine you woke up this morning, had breakfast, and went about your business. But instead of clothes, you stuck toast, scrambled eggs, and fried bacon to your body. Odd? Yes. But what else can you do? On the way to the bus, a bird might swoop down and grab you. Okay, this technique works for the emerald moth caterpillar. The bug sticks flower petals to itself and dines on those same flowers. There, now the analogy makes sense. When this flower suit goes bad, the caterpillar collects a new one. It uses its silk to stick the petals on, and thus goes the cycle of this little guy's life of playing dress-up every day.